All right, Mr. Telefero TV, how's everybody doing out there? Let's correct a couple of things that I said yesterday. First off, I called Elamai all in my video yesterday, and I did not want to disrespect her. I just don't hear a name that often. I hear the records, I just don't hear a name. It's Elamai. One of my subscribers corrected the heck out of me yesterday, and I appreciate you for that. The second thing I said was that the remix was too booed up. I think I might have mentioned that or inferred that. This record was Trip, okay? So all this controversy over is over Elamai's Trip. So here is what happened, all right? Let me just justify this as quickly as possible. Jacquees posted this tweet showing that he was sad, kind of quote tweeting an outlet that was making light of the fact that he has a remix to Elamai's Trip and it was taken down on all streaming platforms by someone in Elamai's team, all right? Now, to think, the internet just runs with stuff. To think that Elamai is online, because apparently her and Jacquees have some sort of a friendship, they did a tour together. To think that Elamai is online, manually saying, take this down, I don't want this up, I don't want this person to do it. No, that's not what happened is, when you bring your music, when you upload music to SoundCloud and YouTube, you go through a copyright submission process automatic. The owner of the music, no matter who it is, has the rights to say, no, I want to get rid of this music that somebody else posted, or yes, I want to keep it up. Maybe I want to make money off of it. Maybe I ain't even concerned about the owner of the music. Sometimes it goes back to the label. If they manage the artist, they have the rights to do whatever they want with the music. Elamai is signed to DJ Mustard's 10 Summers. They own this music. Again, Elamai has some ownership in it, but the end all be all goes back to DJ Mustard's 10 Summers. With that being said, Jacquees made this remix, this phenomenal remix to Trip. I can't believe I said booed up yesterday. And the remix probably did better than Elamai's Trip did. I'm like almost sure of it. I heard that remix once with Jacquees and it's really good. It's a really great record. And DJ Mustard and company was like, no, we're not going to leave this record up. First off, it's performing better than the original record. And second off, if Jacquees want to get on the record, can we work something out for an official remix? We don't make money off this. Why would we allow this? This has nothing to do with Elamai. This is all about DJ Mustard and his company making a financial decision. As a matter of fact, he headed over to his InstaSnap to clear this up for those who were thinking Elamai's out here just saying, no, Jacquees, I don't want my... That's not how this works. DJ Mustard said this, our artists don't send cease and desist, we do. When you monetize content that you don't own, you are stealing and no one steals from 10 Summers. Ella had no say in the matter and any platform reporting any differently is spreading falsities. This is simply a press or a marketing plan or some strategy to deviate from the narrative that Ella is breaking records left and right because the music she's making is cutting through straight to the fans at a rate people haven't seen in years. Ella's career started by doing covers and we support all her fans and fellow artists doing the same. Look, DJ Mustard and his team, they have a point, all right? You can't get mad. Only in our community do we get mad over stuff like that. You know damn well if Jacquees would have made a remix to a pop record, tried to throw it up on YouTube, SoundCloud, and all that, if that pop artist would have wanted that track took down, there would have been no complaints from Jacquees. It just doesn't make sense. Jacquees is such a talent that I get mad sometimes that he makes these phenomenal remixes because he's just a lover of music. Instead of just making some kind of deviation of that record for himself. I get mad at that because he's so talented, but he just loves other people's beats. That's the only thing. Like, I think Jacquees should focus that energy into his own music so a problem like this shouldn't come up. I get it. Like I said yesterday, Jacquees comes up in the same area. Me and him are close in age. He comes up through that era, and I've met Jacquees before, by the way. Good dude. He comes up in that area that I'm from. We came up with mixtapes being everything. Like Gucci, Wayne, these dudes would make tons of records over other people's beats, man. That's the era we came up in with nobody complaining because everybody was eating through the mixtape circuit. But we're in a completely different era. People don't even hop on other people's beats like that anymore because you can't throw that up on Spotify, iTunes, and Apple Music and all that. We're in a different era, man. That era of just using other people's music for your own gain is damn near done, especially when you're an artist as hot as Jacquees can be at times, because Let's call it. His record was hotter than LMI's Trip. His remix was hotter than that. And they like, nah, that's just bad business. They don't win in that in no regard. Damn near people would have thought that it was Jacquees record. And that's not the case. It just doesn't make good business sense. And I ain't mad at no parties involved for doing what they had to do, especially DJ Mustard's camp. It just doesn't make good business sense. I get it. Our era, we did that all the time. We listened to music that came through. Some of Wayne's best all time came over. His best verses all time came over other people's beats. That's the truth of the matter. And it didn't matter about monetizing it, because hell, they were still played on the radio. And honest to God, true, Wayne was still touring some of that music, right? We're in a different era, and I think we're in a better era, right? Though that seems like a selfish thing to say, no, we're finding ways to get stricter about copyrighting our music and our community. Our culture is always stolen. We're getting better with that. We're getting better with that, and I'm fine with that. Thank y'all so much for the time, love, support. Now, next is dances. The next thing we got to find out is how to copyright a dance. There's no damn reason Fortnite should have Blockboy JB dance on it, and he don't make a penny off that. I see niggas calling it the Fortnite dance. No damn way. Thank y'all so much for the time, love, support. Well, DJ Mustard cleared that up quickly. I don't think we're going to hear any more about that from Jacquees and company. I'm out. I came from nothing, but I want everything God has for me. I interview celebrities. I talk sports. I still represent the culture.
I got the kids. They tuned in.
You are now tuned in.
Tuned in.
Yo, we locked in right now, Mr.
Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Shout out to Mr. Telefair.
You watching Mr. Telefair TV.
Mr. Telefair TV. Here with the Triple B's, you can't do nothing but win.